This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about two things that I think go a long way to help secure a Microsoft 365 account. The first one I've talked about before, but I want to repeat it again because it's so important: multi-factor authentication. And the other one is another thing that has to do with authentication, and it's called company branding. It's to help your users make a better decision when they're logging into sites. And I'm going to show you quickly how to do both. First item is you want to go to your app on your phone and look for the Microsoft Authenticator app and make sure you install it and get it ready to go. You're going to want to make sure that you add it in a certain way. So as it asks you for information, for example, you do not want to add a personal account. You do want it to send you notifications. You want to make sure you skip over adding a non-Microsoft account, and you want to go over to Here for Work and you want to get ready to add that account. You'll then go to the website, aka Microsoft Setup, MFA Setup, and then you'll log in with your account. This is your global admin account. And in this case, it had already a passcode for my phone, but you probably will not have that. Once you get logged in, you'll want to set up the Authenticator app. It's going to put up a code. You then use your phone to take an image of that code. You'll hold your phone up to it, and it will automatically send your account to the Authenticator app and get it ready to go. The resulting final page will indicate it's tied to your phone. Now, from here, you can set up additional devices. So especially for the global administrator account, you may want to have a backup device. Let's say an iPhone and something else. An Android device, an application, things like that. You can also set it up that there's an alternative phone number in use, an office phone, or a specific authenticated, such as an iPhone or Android phone that it's sent to. All of these options are configurable in the settings. And keep in mind, when you set up multi-factor authentication, you and therefore require users to bring an additional device, such as a cell phone, you might be opening yourself up for additional reimbursement to those employees. You can do what's called whitelisting your office. So for example, if you've got users in your office that never ever log in from any other place other than a fixed location, you can set up that static IP as a trusted location, and therefore those workstations don't have to use multi-factor authentication. Now mind you, at this time, we have not enabled or enforced the two-factor. We've just set it up and gotten it ready to go. Microsoft recommends that you set up what's called emergency or break glass accounts, so that should something happen to either the account or perhaps multi-factor authentication is having issues, that you can log in outside of that protected account and turn off MFA temporarily. So it's recommended that you set up at least two of these emergency accounts. And it's also recommended that when you set up these brand new accounts, and remember, global administrators don't have to pull licenses in Office 365. So when you set up these accounts, you want to set up the password to be an extremely long and complicated password. And in fact, they recommend that you use your password tool to generate a secure password. And what you want to do is do at least a long password. Like, for example, you want to do something like 100 characters. You want to copy that and place that in when you're setting up the account. Save that password. Make sure you put it in a protected spot. And then try not to ever log into that account or use it as at least amount as possible. You'll then want to build a conditional use policy that sets up and requires that administrators have MFA, but excludes these break glass accounts. So you want to set up conditional access policies. You want to call it something descriptive so you remember what it is. You want to go in and you want to choose directory roles, and you want to select at least 9 different roles at a minimum: billing administrator, conditional access administrator, exchange administrator, global administrator, help desk administrator, password administrator, security administrator, and SharePoint administrator, and finally, user administrator. Then under exclude, you want to pick that break glass or emergency access account. If you set up a grouping of emergency access administrators, you want to pick that group. But bottom line, you want to have at least two identified emergency access accounts that are excluded from multi-factor. You then want to pick all cloud applications. And when you start to pick all cloud applications, you'll notice that the rule says, don't lock yourself out. You're going to be impacted by this. So make sure that you choose these selections accordingly. Next, you want to grant, and you want to say grant access and require multi-factor authentication. Now, initially, if you want, you can click it on report only, but later on, you want to come back and enable that and turn that on. Another recommended step I would suggest you do is what's called company branding. If you go into the Azure portal and you go down to company branding, you want to set up a brand new one. Now, I've already gone through the process, but I'll show you what it looks like. And basically what you do is you put images on your logo page so that when the person comes to the final page where they're putting in their password, they actually have the logo of your firm. Now, in this case, I'm borrowing from CSO Online so that when the person logs in, they'll actually see that logo as the final password screen. And then you want to tell people that what to expect so that when they get to that password page, they'll know exactly what they're expected to see. So what the user experience is like is once they put in their username on the website, and at this point in time, it's a generic Microsoft site, when they click next and they're ready to put in the password, you'll notice that it's changed to be branded so that when you log in, you can tell your users when they get to the passwords page, if it doesn't have your logo on it, if it doesn't have the expected look, don't put the password in. Now, obviously, if you're a targeted firm or a large company, and there's a possibility that bad people can code up a password site that looks like your page, you may want to have some sort of agreed upon procedures so that this page changes, your branding changes, let's say once a month. Again, think in terms of how people come into your organization. And I highly recommend that if you have not done so already, please, please, please put on multi-factor at least for those global administrator accounts and do this company branding. It helps your end users know the experience they're supposed to get. As always, don't forget to sign up for the IDG YouTube channel for the tech news of the day. Look out for Tech Talk. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley. See you at CSO Online.